In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Welcome to you all, both online and in church this morning. Today we celebrate that great festival of unknown children, women and men who lived the life of faith. We give thanks for them and we take inspiration from them that throughout the times and perplexities of human history, they have remained faithful, and the call is for us to continue that life of faith. We ask God's blessing on our Diddy disciples and junior disciples, if there are any. Danny will be leading you if you're going out. May God bless you. Rejoice, people of God, praise the Lord. Let us keep the feast in honour of all God's saints, in whose victory the angels rejoice and glorify the Son of God. Since we are surrounded by a great cloud of witnesses, let us also lay aside every weight and the sin that clings so closely, looking to Jesus in penitence and faith. Lord, you are gracious and compassionate. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You are loving to all, and your mercy is over all your creation. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Your faithful servants bless your name and speak of the glory of your kingdom. Lord, have mercy. Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal through Jesus Christ our Lord. Let us pray that we may be strengthened by our communion with all the saints. Almighty God, you have knit together your elect in one communion and fellowship in the mystical body of your Son, Christ our Lord. Grant us grace so to follow your blessed saints in all virtuous and godly living, that we may come to those inexpressible joys that you have prepared for those who truly love you. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
A reading from the Revelation to John. I looked, and there was a great multitude that no one could count, from every nation, from all tribes and peoples and languages, standing before the throne and before the Lamb, robed in white with palm branches in their hands. They cried out in a loud voice, saying, "Salvation belongs to our God who is seated on the throne and to the Lamb." And all the angels stood around the throne and around the elders and the four living creatures. And they fell on their faces before the throne and worshipped God, singing, "Amen. Blessing and glory and wisdom and thanksgiving and honor and power and might be to our God forever and ever. Amen." Then one of the elders addressed me, saying, "Who are these robed in white, and where have they come from?" I said to him, "Sir, you are the one who knows." Then he said to me, "These are they who have come out of the great ordeal. They have washed their robes and made them white in the blood of the Lamb. For this reason, they are before the throne of God and worship him day and night within his temple, and the one who is seated on the throne will shelter them. They will hunger no more and thirst no more. The sun will not strike them, nor any scorching heat. For the Lamb at the center of the throne will be their shepherd, and he will guide them to springs of the water of life, and God will wipe away every tear from their eyes." This is the word of the Lord.
Thank you. letter of John. See what love the Father has given us, that we should be called children of God. And that is what we are. The reason the world does not know us is that it did not know him. Beloved, we are God's children now. What we will be has not yet been revealed. What we do know is this: when he is revealed, we will be like him, for we will see him as he is. And all who have this hope in him purify themselves, just as he is pure. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Be with you.
And also with you.
Hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
When Jesus saw the crowds, he went up the mountain. And after he sat down, his disciples came to him. Then he began to speak and taught them, saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the earth. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be filled. Blessed are the merciful, for they will receive mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. Blessed are those who are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when people revile you and persecute you, and utter all kinds of evil against you falsely on my account. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward is great in heaven. For in the same way they persecuted the prophets who were before you." This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. I want to take you on a journey from what may seem a strange, perhaps even an obtuse angle, but one way of seeing how All Saints and the communion of saints can be seen. First, the communion is a communion of all saints, living and departed, so it includes you and me. Secondly, it isn't a hierarchy with its mostly male big saints at the top and most of us, the rest of us, at the bottom. But we'll come to that later. My guide is the brilliant feminist theologian Elizabeth Johnson, member of the Sisters of St. Joseph, professor emerita at Fordham University, a Jesuit foundation, influenced by the changes brought on by Vatican II. She starts with a text from the Book of Wisdom, where wisdom, Sophia in Greek, which is a female name, passes over holy souls and makes them friends of God and prophets. That's who we are, but aware that some of us may be closer to God than others. As today's gospel proclaims, the road to joining this blessed company is the way of Jesus Christ, crucified and risen, and entails being poor in spirit, merciful, pure of heart, peacemaking, and hungry and thirsty for righteousness, for justice. She notes that the great majority of saints are men, but she sets out to find women in the Bible who may have been exemplary but overlooked. And she begins with Hagar, the Egyptian slave girl of Sarah, Abraham's wife. Using the analysis of the African-American womanist theologian, Dolores Williams. Womanist is a code for black feminists who have felt themselves oppressed by white feminists as well as by the patriarchy, especially, of course, during and after slavery. All these very clever women, whatever next. But don't worry too much about the technical terms. Hagar was the mother of Ishmael by Abraham, because Sarah had not conceived and God seemed to be taking God's time. Sarah suggested that Abraham have a child by her maid, her slave. When Hagar was pregnant, she realized how important she was to Abraham and Sarah and began to act uppity, as they used to say of slaves. Sarah treated Hagar badly, so she ran off into the desert. But there, the angel of the Lord found her and told her to return and to submit to Sarah. The angel, God of course, promised that she would be a mother of a great multitude and to call her son Ishmael, which means God hears. So she names God El Roy, which means God sees. Note that no one consulted Hagar as to whether she wanted to sleep with the 85-year-old Abraham and have his child. She had no choice. I think you know what we would call that today. But let's move on. Then she bore Ishmael, Abraham's first son, who loved him. And when Isaac, the true heir, was finally born 13 years later, Sarah didn't want her around, so they were banished again to the desert, where they were dying of thirst until the angel of the Lord saved them by making a spring nearby. Again, promises were made to her, and she later found a wife for her son Ishmael and became the mother of the Arabs, which is why in the Quran the roles of Isaac and Ishmael are reversed. Dolores Williams sees Hagar as a great role model because she goes through a similar experience for African-American slaves, raped by their masters and hated and attacked by their jealous mistresses. We never think of Hagar as a saint, but don't forget that God spoke to her twice and made promises to her twice. which he never did to Sarah. Indeed, when Sarah heard that she was going to conceive, laughed. Hagar also gave God a name, but most of all, Hagar survived. The other saint is more familiar to us, Mary Magdalene, follower and supporter of Jesus, who stayed with him all the way to the cross when the men ran off and hid. She was the first witness to Jesus' resurrection, and in John's Gospel, clearly has an intimate relationship with Jesus. She was there at Pentecost when the Spirit came upon the believers, but the church turned her into a reformed prostitute, which is not what the Bible says about her at all. These are just two exemplary women, and there are millions more, and men, dead and alive in the world today. They serve as ordinary people who are women and men, the friends of God and prophets. This is a communion of all God's people, and it doesn't have to be a hierarchy. St. Paul, pillar of the church, partnered with Peter as the apostle to the Gentiles, is a saint like you and me, and said that in Christ there is no longer male and female, Jew or Greek, slave or free, for all of you are one in Christ Jesus. I've always had a sense that when he's writing to Philemon about his runaway slave Onesimus, Paul really wants to say that in Christ we shouldn't own each other at all. But for some reason he can't quite bring himself to say that. Rather presumptuous on my part, perhaps. Maybe one day I'll get to ask him, but I suspect I'll be in a long queue. It is this communion of all the saints of the past and present, all the saints, lovers of God, from every culture and faith, who make what is the third element of this communion powerfully significant for us in today's world. That is, that all of creation is part of this communion as well. We are all, past and present, in communion with God's Spirit, each other, and with the created world. And our response to the environmental crisis is crucial, and the responsibility of all our communion of saints. Right now, we celebrate this Eucharist for all saints. We are in communion with all the saints, past and present, around the table. We are the friends of God and prophets, committed to all humanity and indeed to all God's creation. Amen.
Renew our trust in the faith once delivered to the saints. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true Lord from true Lord, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation he came down from heaven, was incarnate from the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and was made man. For our sake he was crucified on Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end.
Spirit,
the Lord, the giver of life,
who proceeds from the Father and the Son,
who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified,
who has spoken through the prophets.
We believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church.
We acknowledge your baptism for the forgiveness of sins.
We look for the resurrection of the dead
and the life of the world to come.
Merciful Lord, strengthen all Christian people by your Holy Spirit, that we may live as royal priesthood and a holy nation, to the praise of Jesus Christ our Saviour. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Bless Christopher, our Bishop, Justin, our Archbishop, and Jonathan, Bishop of Croydon, and all ministers of your Church, that by faithful proclamation of your word, we may be built on the foundation of the apostles and prophets into a holy temple in the Lord. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Empower us by the gift of your holy and life-giving Spirit, that we may be transformed into the likeness of Christ from glory to glory. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Give to the world and its peoples the peace that comes from above, that they may find Christ's way of freedom and life. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Hold in your embrace all who witness to your love in the service of the poor and needy, all who minister to the sick and dying, and all who bring light to those in darkness. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Touch and heal all those whose lives are scarred by sin or disfigured by pain, that raised from death to life in Christ, their sorrow may be turned to eternal joy. We pray for the healing of Neville and Celeste Prinsloo, Roy Ray, Robbie Middleton, Christopher Love, David Ogundeji, Lorna Gauthier, Amanda Smith, David Maitland, Simon Gabe, Michael Hale, Vinette and Mike Melbourne, Michael Cooper, Adam Phillips, Peter Bibby, Chanet Kempson, Philippa Pierce, Alison Omelia, Julie Lowe, Anne Newman, Naomi Ionu, Alan Drija, June McCullum, Carmen Alviraz, Paul Allen, and Po Wong. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Remember in your mercy all those gone before us who have been well-pleasing to you from eternity. Preserve in your faith your servants on earth, guide us to your kingdom, and grant us your peace at all times. We remember the recently departed, Pamela Lerwell, Miranda Grassi, Oliver Stubbs, Jack Bridge, Margaret Morris, Phyllis Simmons, Andy Davies, Joseph Hogan, and Terry Paxton. We give thanks for and remember past priests, benefactors, friends, and all whose year's mind occurs this week. Ernest Fanton, priest, Violet Bamber, Florence Webb, Irene Loft, Eric Morris, Flora Dyke, Doris Adams, Margaret Fisher, Annie Corey, Norman Cunningham, Victor Johnston, Verger, Arthur Charman, Olive Nixon, Adrian Jacobs, priest, Shay Hall, Bertram Freestone, Frank Wilkins. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Hasten the day when many will come from east and west, from north and south, and sit at table in your kingdom. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We give you thanks for the whole company of your saints in glory, with whom in fellowship we join our prayers and praises. By your grace, may we, like them, be made perfect in your love.
Blessing and glory and wisdom,
thanksgiving and honor and power be to our God forever and ever. Amen. We are fellow citizens with the saints and of the household of God through Christ our Lord, who came and preached peace to those who were far off and those who were near. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Let us offer each other a respectful but distant peace.
Thank you.
Pray, my sisters and brothers, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at our hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of his church.
As the grain once scattered in the fields, and the grapes once dispersed on the hillside, and now reunited on this table in bread and wine, so, Lord, may your whole church soon be gathered together from the corners of the earth into your kingdom. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Jesus Christ our Lord. And now we give you thanks, most gracious God, surrounded by a great cloud of witnesses. The glorious company of the apostles praise you. The noble fellowship of prophets praise you. The white-robed army of martyrs praise you. We, your holy church, acclaim you, in communion with angels and archangels, and with all who served you on earth and worship you now in heaven. We raise our voices to proclaim your glory, forever praising you and singing.
Thank you.
praise and bless you, loving Father, through Jesus Christ our Lord. And as we obey his command, send your Holy Spirit, that broken bread and wine outpoured may be for us the body and blood of your dear Son. On the night before he died, he had supper with his friends, and taking bread, he praised you. He broke the bread, gave it to them, and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." When supper was ended, he took the cup of wine. Again, he praised you, gave it to them, and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." So, Father, we remember all that Jesus did. In him we plead with confidence, his sacrifice made once for all upon the cross. Bringing before you the bread of life and the cup of salvation, we proclaim his death and resurrection until he comes in glory. Great is the mystery of faith. Christ has died, Christ is risen, Christ will come again. Lord of all life, help us to work together for that day when your kingdom comes, and justice and mercy will be seen in all the earth. Look with favor on your people, gather us in your loving arms, and bring us with Mary, the Mother of God, John the Evangelist, Alban the Martyr, and all the saints to feast at your table in heaven. Through Christ and with Christ and in Christ, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory are yours, O loving Father, forever and ever. Amen. With saints and martyrs through the ages, let us pray with confidence as our Saviour has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share in one. I heard the voice of a great multitude saying, "Alleluia! The Lord our God has entered into his kingdom. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb." Let us pray. Lord of heaven, in this Eucharist, you have brought us near to an innumerable company of angels and to the spirits of the saints made perfect. As in this food of our earthly pilgrimage, we have shared their fellowship, so may we come to share their joy in heaven through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Almighty God, we thank you for feeding us with the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him we offer you our souls and bodies to be a living sacrifice. Send us out in the power of your Spirit to live and work to your praise and glory. Amen.
Very warm welcome to you all this morning, St. John's. Thank you for abiding by the rules. We'll keep you up to date as we find out. The bishop's announced that he's going to have a meeting tomorrow, which is exciting. And from that meeting, hopefully, he'll be able to tell us something about the government's mind and the church's mind. I would encourage you, if you feel inclined to do so, because we manage ourselves very well here, do write to the Archbishop of Canterbury, drop him an email, say, don't say Father John said, right? do tell him that Father Andy did. and just make Thank your thoughts known to him. And let's see how this week works out. So let's just pretend that everything's going to be suspended for next week on, possibly. But worship will go back to online if that's the case. Unfortunately, this month is going to be the beginning of our new music venture, and it's been wonderful to welcome some new singers into our midst. Thank you for the music and for the songs you've been singing. And that will. and that will obviously continue into December if we're allowed back ever again. But tonight, as Father Thomson's sermon, if this morning is about the whole saints, the whole people of God, known and unknown, it's so wonderful to see in our processions so many familiar names of the departed who we remember still. And tonight we remember the more intimate people of God that we know, those who've nurtured us, who've given us life, those who have encouraged us and brought us to faith. There's still forms at the back of church for you to fill in names, to put your names of your faithful class ones on so they can be remembered tonight. Please write them to hear me. And can I also encourage you to come tonight, because this might be a bit of a barren period for us in terms of worship. And the choir are going to sing for his requiem, and we're going to remember the names of those who we've loved and who now reside in God's nearer presence. So don't just put a name down or hundreds of names down and leave it at that. Come and join in the intercessions and the prayers and thanksgiving in a more intimate way tonight. And that's at 6 o'clock here in church, and it'll be another Mass, but it'll be again like this morning. I suspect the AVCM is being postponed, I suspect the concert's being postponed, and all that sort of stuff. So just bear with us, let's see what we can do. Can I encourage you also just to remember that even though things might be suspended here, public attendance, church will remain open because we have the food bank, and we will remain open and safe for private prayer. That's non-negotiable. So do use the space over these next couple of weeks if you can, and perhaps coincide bringing some food from the food bank with remembering this and yourself before God. But I think that's everything, is it?
Mm-hmm.
Yes. Okay. God's blessing.
You can quote me to the Archbishop. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
May God, who kindled the fire of his love in the hearts of the saints, pour upon you the riches of his grace.
Amen.
May he give you joy in their fellowship and a share in their praises.
Amen.
May he strengthen you to follow them in the way of holiness and to come to the full radiance of glory.
Amen.
And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always.
Amen.
Following God's saints in the ways of holiness and truth, go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. Thank you.